Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in today's session, we'll discuss about the conditional statements in shell scripting. So in this conditional statements, so we are going to discuss about a simple if statement. So the syntax and the example. So here I will show you the syntax, and on the terminal we'll see the implementation part practical. So first one is a simple if. If else, if, elif, else, and also case. And we'll cover this case in the next session. So in today's session, we'll discuss about these three things. That is a simple if else, and if, elif, else. Now, coming to the simple if. So the syntax for this simple if is, so this is for simple if. That means, see, before going to the syntax, if we'll write the true block. So if in if we'll write the true block statements, and in else we'll write the false block statements. So what is this true block and a false block? So in this particular conditional statements, the name itself indicates we are going to write a condition, and based upon the result of that condition, we are executing the instructions whether the condition is true or false, right? So we know that a condition is a operands with a relational operator. So any condition, if you consider any condition, the result of this condition can be either true or false. So we have to write the condition. Whenever it is true, we need to write the statements here, and whenever it is false, we need to write the statements here. Similarly, this is a true block. We should write in if, and this one should be written in else. And just one thing you need to remember, where we have to write the condition, and this condition should be written in if only. We have to write the condition in if only. So we should not write the condition in else part, right? Now let us check the simple if. So here it is a simple if. The name itself indicates we need to write the instructions for only the true block. That means we are giving instructions whenever the condition becomes true, and we are not going to give any sort of instructions what should happen if the condition becomes false, because this is a simple if. There is no else. So one more thing you need to remember: without if, we should not write else, and without else, we can write if, because the condition will return in if block itself. So the syntax for simple if followed by the condition, then go with the statements. So we need to write the statements. Statement 1, statements 2, etc. And at the end of the if block, we have to represent it as fi. So this fi represents that this the block of if ends. Okay, the block of conditional statements ends. So if you are writing if else, at the end of the else we need to write this fi. This means it ends the conditional statements, right? So this is the simple if. Now coming to the, so here these statements, statement 1, statement 2, all these statements will be executed only when this condition becomes true. When the condition becomes false, we are not writing any instructions, nothing will happen. So I will execute a program and I will show you, so that if you are still having any doubts, those doubts will be clarified, right? So this is a syntax for simple if. That means we are writing only the true block statements. And the next one is a if else. If else. So if is a true block, else is a false block. So we need to write the instructions in the if whenever the condition becomes true. And we have to write the statements in else what to be executed if the condition becomes false. So the same syntax, instead of fi, here we need to write else and write on the statements. So statement 3, statement 4, etc. And end the conditional statement with fi. End the conditional statement with fi. So this is a syntax for if else. So here we are writing the two different block of statements. So this is comes under the true block and this comes under the false block. So based upon the result of the condition, so either it may be true or false. If the condition is true, this block will be executed and this block will not be executed. So only one thing is executed, either true block or false block. So if the condition becomes false, directly the control will execute the else part. It doesn't move to the if block, the true block, right? So this is the if else, that means condition true block and false block. And then the next one is if elif else. So once you check the condition, it becomes false. And again, if you want to check one more condition, that means if you want to check multiple conditions, then what I have said, we have to write the condition on if block only. So without if block, we should not write else. So in else block, we should not write any condition. So if you want to check one more condition, simply use the elif. That means else if. So again, we are having if. So here we can write the condition, the second condition. Right? Whenever this condition becomes true, whenever this condition becomes true, this block will be executed. Whenever the condition is false, again it moves to the second block and again it will check for the condition. And here also we need to write then. Okay, if condition then statement 1, statement 2, elif condition then statement 3, statement 4. And finally we can write the else part. Else statement 5 and so on. Finally write down the end of conditional statement fi. So this is the syntax for if, elif, else. So in order to check multiple conditions, we are going to use this if, elif, else. And we have to write the condition only on the if block. So we are combining the else and if and we are directly calling it as a elif. So elif, write down the condition, then the statement 3, statement 4. So first this condition will be checked. If this condition is true, this block will be executed. If the condition is false, again it will move to the next block. It will check one more time the condition, another condition. And if this condition is true, so again, if this condition is true, this block will be executed. And again, if the condition is false, then else part will be executed. So this is how we can execute the conditional statement. So this is the syntax and we'll move on to the system and I will show you the execution of these conditional statements in the terminal. We'll take one example and we'll solve it, right? So let's move on to the system.
Hello friends, so just now we have seen the syntax for the decision statements in shell scripting. That is, we have seen the simple if, if else, and if, elif, else. So we'll see by implementing a small program. So first let us open the Ubuntu. So we'll create one file, so simple if, right? Now go to the insert mode by pressing I and write down here, read the character one, I mean read any variable, so read n and check if, see, just follow the syntax, give the space for everything. So if space square brackets space the value of n means dollar $n space hyphen gt is for greater than space 0 space closed, square braces, right? Give the space for everything, right? So if the given number is greater than 0, the syntax is then, what we have to print? Echo positive number, right? So after closing of if, we need to use fi, So that represent this is a if block. That represent this is completely a if block. So just save this one. Execute sh simple if. So give the value some 40. So already we'll get it is a greater than 0. So we got a positive number. And once again, we'll check with the one more condition. So simple if give minus 10. So nothing will be printed because we are not specifying anything to print whether the given number is not positive number. So that is a simple if. See, so just in this we have written only the true block. So we are not writing the false block. We are not giving any instruction for the for the Unix that what to be print if the condition fails. So we are just giving the positive, that means a true block. So that's why if it is true, the statement will be printed. If it is false, nothing will be printed. Right? Now, coming to the second one, that is if else. So create one more program, if else. So insert, read the value. So read n. So I will write echo also. Enter value for n. Right? Read n and if space square brackets open space value of n which is a dollar n space hyphen gt greater than space zero space closed braces, then what we have to do, echo positive number and give else, that is a false block. Else what we have to print, echo negative number. If you want to print the value, simply you can also use the value. So $n is a positive number, and here also you can give $n is a negative number. And after completion of the if, just close fi. So fi, just save this one and execute sh if else. So enter the value of n 40, so which is a positive number. And once again we'll check. So minus 30 is a negative number, right? So it's very simple, but we need to remember the spaces. So for everything you need to give the space. Space is most important. So if space square braces space the value space the relational operator space the value space and close braces. Just follow the same thing, the syntax. And if block, if we'll write if followed by the condition, then we need to write the true block statements, else false block statements, and represent fi to know that it is an end of if else. Right? Now we'll go with the one more thing, that is if elif else. If elif else, that means if you want to check multiple conditions at a time, we can go with this if elif else. So insert first take the value, echo enter value for a, read a, and again echo enter value for b, read b. So we are taking two values, and now we want to check the relation between two values. So the relation between two values can be a is equal to b or a greater than b or a less than b. So we need to represent that. So first write down if space square braces space dollar a space hyphen eq space dollar b space square braces, then echo dollar a and dollar b are equal, right? So if the condition becomes true, that implies so a value and b value are equal. Else, and I need to check one more condition. So elif, we need to use a elif, because in the else block we should not write the condition. If you want to write the condition, again you need to include the if, right? So else if. In C language, we'll use else if, but here we'll use directly elif. Elif. Elif followed by the condition. Give the condition. $a hyphen gt space dollar b space close the braces. That means if a is greater than b, if a is greater than b, then echo dollar a, sorry, dollar a is greater than dollar b. And next, simply you can go with the else. So if both the conditions are false, simply we can say dollar b is greater than dollar a, right? So echo dollar a is less than dollar b. Now after ending the if block, simply go with fi, right? Save the thing, execute sh if elif else. Value of a is 20, value of b is 30. So yeah, okay, something we have missed, we'll include that one. So here elif, and here you need to include then. Elif then, right? Save sh if elif else. So enter the value of a is 20, b is 30. So that 20 is less than 30. We got the result, 20 is less than 30. We'll go with the one more input. So I will give 30 and 30. So 30 and 30 are equal. So both are equal. And I will go with the another case. 40, 10. So 40 is greater than 10. Right? So like this, we can implement the decision making statements, the conditional statements, that is simple if, if else, and if elif else. Right? So hope you understood this one. So if you are having any doubt regarding this one, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section. Definitely I will try to clarify all your doubts. If you really enjoyed my session, like my session, share my session with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.